this hour, the federal government shutdown appears to be ending. A look at how lawmakers reached a deal. And the end of that federal government shutdown tops our news at 4. Republican and Democratic leaders in the U.S. Senate reached an agreement on a deal to end the shutdown today. Kimberly Gill in the newsroom with what this deal involves. Kim.
Hi, Karen. Good afternoon. Some critics say this might be another case of kicking the can down the road until February 8th. The Senate has agreed to vote on a bill to keep funding the government until that date, with a pledge from majority Republicans to debate a new immigration bill between now and that date. A bipartisan group of senators worked through the weekend to come up with a plan they took to party leaders this morning. Republicans get the votes they need to end the shutdown. Democrats get the pledge to take up the issues of the so-called Dreamers Act, those Dreamers who were brought to the U.S. illegally while they were children. Party leaders see this deal as the best way forward.
I think we've learned anything during this process is that a strategy to shut down the government over the issue of illegal immigration is something the American people didn't understand.
In a few hours, the government will reopen. We have a lot to do.
The Senate voted to end a filibuster on the budget. It must still vote on the short-term budget deal, though. Then the House must approve it. That is expected. And then, of course, the president must sign off on it. Now, the compromise deal that broke the deadlock came from the work of about 24 senators from both parties, and actually one of them was Democratic Senator Gary Peters of Michigan. So, Karen, we'll continue to follow everything here for you. We'll have more tonight on the news at 5. All right. Thank you very much, Ken. Appreciate that. We have some breaking news of more fallout in the case of sports doctor Larry Nassar, who has admitted to sexually assaulting young female athletes. 3 top members of USA Gymnastics have announced their resignations. The group's chairman, vice chairman, and treasurer are all leaving their posts. Critics have said USA Gymnastics failed to protect gymnasts from Nassar and from abusive coaches. The resignations are effective immediately. Meantime, more than 100 women have now addressed the Lansing court where sports doctor Larry Nassar will be sentenced for sexual assault. The women who were victimized by Nassar during his years at Michigan State University, USA Gymnastics, and in treatment of young female athletes told their stories to a judge and addressed Nassar himself. One of those speaking today is just 15 years old.
My last treatment was in August 2016. A week later, he was let go by MSU. I'm possibly the last child he will ever assault. MSU Sports Medicine charged me for those appointments. My mom is still getting billed for appointments where I was sexually assaulted.
And we will bring